In this class, we are going to discuss about D flip-flop. So here sometimes D flip-flop is called as delay flip-flop, and sometimes someone it may call it as data flip-flop. So whatever it may be, D flip-flop we can design by using SR flip-flop. Why we design this D flip-flop means, we know SR flip-flop in that we are having no change condition, set condition, reset condition and one indetermined condition. Totally we are having four states, so we need to process that four states, that it requires four time cycles or anything. So if you want only set and reset, then no need to use that SR flip-flop. That means already one state is wasted there. So that's why if you want to get set and reset, then you can go for this D flip-flop rather than taking SR flip-flop. So the circuitry is very similar to SR flip-flop. Just by taking a NOT gate in between S and R, you know this is SR flip-flop. So now I am just taking a NOT gate, that NOT in the form of NAND. So I am just clubbing two inputs of NAND, it will act as NOT gate. So I am just taking NOT gate in between this S and R, and I am making this as data line, my data line. So here you can observe, now D is giving directly, that is nothing but D is equal to S, and D is equivalent to R equivalent to D bar. So now here I am going to deal the same thing, so which I done previously for SR flip-flop, that is, so to get the expression or to see the operation, we need to take truth table for any sequential circuit, not only for this flip-flops, for any sequential circuit. After having circuit diagram or logic diagram, you need to consider truth table to observe the functionality. So now you can see only one input, so another input may be your present state, because to get your output, that means next state, I always telling you that your next state is your required output for any sequential circuit. That means Qn plus 1 is your output. What are the inputs for this sequential circuit means? So actual inputs, whatever you are observing at input side, those are inputs, and present states, whatever state that is in this time, the machine is in this time, that is called as present state. That present state we are giving as feedback input. You can observe like this. So these two are inputs here, that means data input and Qn, present state inputs are inputs, and output is next state. So now here I always telling you that, here I already told you that, so always present state we don't know about this. The present state may be either 0 or 1, we don't know about this. That's why I am taking don't care of this present state, that may be either 0 or 1. So here the combination of data we can give, as this is a single variable, the data we may give in 0 or 1, data input may be either 0 or 1. For example, if you are having two input variables like S and R, you can give combination of 4, 0, 0, 0, 1 like that. But here the input line make as only one line, with one variable we may have only two combinations, that means either 0 or 1. So now here I am going to consider, I am going to take the cases. So first case, your first case is equivalent to, so D equal to 0 case, I am considering D equal to 0. If D is equal to 0, the input for this gate is equivalent to 0. And here you are getting, as you are having NOT gate here, you are getting 1 here. So always clock pulse you can consider like clock is on, that means clock is 1. Always you need to consider clock is 1, otherwise your circuit will be in the same condition. You can check, if clock is equivalent to 0, definitely you are getting, without knowing other input values, without knowing input data, your gates, these gates output goes to 1 1. When it gives 1 1, your circuit is going to no change condition. So now see here, so always you are taking clock as on. So here when you have clock is equivalent to 1, and when you are having your data as 0, your circuit having inputs like this. So now 0 into 1 whole bar, you are getting 1 here. And here 0, here you are having 1 into 1 whole bar, you are getting 0 here. So now, which gate you need to process means, see here, as these are NAND gates, I think it's better to propagate first like this and after like this, because here you are getting value, with that value you are going to get this value. So here 0 into anything, that means Qn, 0 into Qn bar is equal to 1 here. This one I am propagating like this, 1 into 1 whole bar you are getting 0. So 1 into Qn plus 1 bar you are having here. So that one I am propagating to top side. Or if you are having any doubt like this, so you just propagate your normal line, that means you just take equation for Qn plus 1. So every time to make clarity or to design any sequential circuit, just follow only one procedure. Finally, you need only next state, that's it. So I am just taking when D equal to 0, my next state I am writing like this, I am taking up to here I process Qn plus 1 equal to 1 into Qn bar whole bar, 1 into Qn bar whole bar, this is nothing but Qn. Now by seeing itself we can't say what is the Qn value, then we are going to complement port. If value is available here either 0 or 1, no need to go for complement. That means Qn plus 1 port, this port. If here you got value, no need to go for this port. But here you got some unknown value, we don't know that value. So that's why to get clarity about that value, you are just checking your complement port. If you got value in complement port, then you can apply that reference to normal port value. That means, so here this is equal to, so 0 into Qn whole bar. So 0 into Qn whole bar. So here you are getting 0 into anything, 0 whole bar means 1s. So if you got Qn plus 1 whole bar is equivalent to 1, definitely we can reflect this result here. If Qn plus 1 bar is equal to 1, automatically Qn plus 1 value may be 0. That means whatever this unknown Qn value is there, because of this, this is equal to 0. That means your Qn plus 1 output is equal to 0 in this condition. So without having idea about Qn may be anything, your value will goes to 0. So here this is called as reset state. Reset state. D flip flop is only having two states. So reset and set states. So it needs only two time cycles. So second case is D is equal to 1 case. In this Qn plus 1 you need to define. So if D is equal to 1, that same 1 coming here and 0 coming here. So now 0 into clock whole bar you are getting 1 here, and 1 into 1 whole bar you are getting 0 here. Now Qn plus 1 is equal to 0 into Qn bar whole bar. So I am writing 0 into Qn bar whole bar. Here you are getting directly, so 0 bar means 1. You got value in Qn plus 1. Whatever you needed for that, you got value directly. Then no need to go for complement port and get reference from that. So here you can write when D equal to 1, Qn plus 1 is equal to 1. So you got set state. Now I want to take, I want to draw my block diagram, or I want to take expression for D flip flop. To get expression for D flip flop, so I am just taking K map. How many variable K map we need to consider means, whatever output functionality is there, that is the source of expression. So for this, the two input variables are D and Qn. So two variable K map you need to consider to get the expression. So I am considering two variable K map in that one is input variable D and other is your present state Qn. So I am taking combination with 0, 1 and you are getting when you are having 1 means when. So here you are having two states 0, 1. In these two cases, when D equal to 1, either Qn is 0 also you are getting 1. Either Qn is 1 also you are getting 1. So that means when D is equal to 1, both cases of Qn will provide you 1. So here I am just grouping like this. So now this prime implicant value will provide the equation for a D flip-flop. So sideways it's covering single cell. So D, and here top wise no combination. This is equal to D. So therefore for D flip-flop your Qn plus 1 is equivalent to D. So this is the expression for D flip-flop. So here you can observe whatever you are providing at T, same thing you are getting at next state, that means output. So if you provided 1, you got 1. When you provided 0, you got 0. Same thing we got as expression. This is also called as transparent flip-flop. So that means whatever data available at input, that can be available at output, that is available at output. So that's why this flip-flop, particularly D flip-flop, is also called as so data or transparent flip-flop. So here in this D flip-flop, just we changed this circuit. That means we are just adding, we are just clubbing S and R inputs with a NOT gate. This is about D flip-flop, and in the next class we will design different flip-flops like JK and T, all this.